Hello. One of the questions I'm most often asked by my students has to do with how to mix the colour green. At first this seems quite a simple question with a simple answer. We all know that yellow and blue make green. However, because there are so many greens and because there are no pure blues and yellows, the topic is a lot more complicated than it first appears. Because pigments aren't pure, meaning there are no pure blues or pure yellows, they almost all have one or two of the other primary colours. You have, for instance, French ultramarine is a lovely blue, but it has a little bit of red in it. And some yellows have a little bit of red in them, and some have a little bit of blue, or maybe both. The earth colours, for instance, have some of each of the three primary colours in them. So that is the first problem, the fact that there are no pure pigments, but we can use an understanding of that to allow us to help us mix anything from a bright green colour to a dull green colour. In addition to the problem of the pigments themselves, the atmosphere also has an impact on how greens change in the environment. For instance, if you had a tree in the foreground that has a particular greenish foliage, that same tree maybe 400 yards away, its green would look different because of the effect of the atmosphere. So you have to take this into account as well when you're mixing greens. Anyway, I think it's a lovely subject. Hopefully I can make it a little bit more understandable so that you don't have these problems mixing greens in your own work in the future. So let's start by looking at which colours I use when I'm mixing my greens. So one of those colours is French ultramarine. It's what we call a warm blue. It's a blue that leans a little bit to the red. Another colour I often use is raw umber. It's a slightly yellowish brown. The key word there is the yellow. When you mix it with French ultramarine, it can give you a very dull grey looking green. Oreolin, this is a yellow, very vibrant yellow. It leans just a hint towards the green, meaning it has a fraction of blue in it. And the fourth colour that I generally use is cobalt turquoise. It's a blue that leans a little bit to the green. You could also refer to it as a greenish blue. And you'll understand why I've picked these four colours. You can use other blues and yellows to create your greens, but these are the ones I use, and I have a particular logic as to why I use them and how I use them. There are occasions when I will use other colours. For instance, this is cadmium yellow. Sometimes I'll use that in a green. This is cad orange. If I have a very orangish sky, I might use some of that when I mix my green, because the light from the sky will affect the green in the landscape. I have viridian in my palette, which is a pre-mixed green. I primarily use that when I'm painting waves. I haven't found a colour that so easily represents the green of a wave as it crests and starts to form. So that is the only green, pure green, that I have in my palette. I rarely use it. It's, it's very specialised. Most of the time, cobalt turquoise replaces it. Before we start mixing paints, let's just have a quick summary on greens and what happens to them in the environment. You can see how as the greens move closer to you, they get to be more vibrant and purer looking. Then as they move further into the distance, their colours become duller and bluer, and they also become lighter. And this is one of the reasons I think why people have trouble mixing greens, because they don't take that into account. If we start by looking at the colours in my palette, so this is Oriolan. I'll just clean the top a little bit. It's a slightly green-leaning yellow, which means it has a small amount of blue in it. Then here, this is raw umber. It's a slightly yellowish-leaning brown. And here we have cobalt turquoise, which is a, you know, greenish leaning blue. So when you mix, and because blue and yellow make green, when you see anything with green in it, you know it's got some of those two colours, the blue and the yellow. So effectively in my palette, this is what I use as a green, but then I modify it, as you'll see when we start painting on the paper. And here's some French ultramarine, and it leans slightly to the red. Okay. Now, how do I use these colours when mixing my greens? If we start with a bright green that's close to us, I start with some aureolin, and then a small amount of the cobalt turquoise. And that gives me my brightest green. Let me make that a little bit thicker to make, just like when you're baking a cake, if you want to make the mixture thicker, you add more paint and no more water. There we go. Now, that's my first green, and this is just cobalt turquoise and aureolin. As objects move further away from you, they get lighter. So the way to do that is you add more water to your mixture. So with watercolor, you just add more water. And as you add more water, it becomes lighter and lighter. As I mentioned before, one of the influences on your greens is the atmosphere. So as a green moves further away from you, it becomes duller. And from my palette of four colours that I use for mixing greens, I have two colours that can be used to dull the green. The first one is raw umber. So let me first start by, there's pure green, which is a secondary colour made up of just blue and yellow. In this case, cobalt turquoise and the aureolin. If I want to dull that, I can grab some of my raw umber. Now, raw umber is a brown, and all browns have the three primary colours in them, which means they all have some red, yellow and blue. And that red, being the complement of green on the colour wheel, dulls the green. So if I paint that, you can see how this is dulled, right? The other colour I can use to dull my greens is French ultramarine. Now, French ultramarine, as I've already mentioned, is a blue that has a small amount of red in it. So and again, it's that red that dulls the blue. So here I've got the brightest green, and I've dulled it with raw umber here and French ultramarine here. Which one I use, and sometimes I'll use both, is dependent on the scene I'm painting and on what green I want to produce. When I add raw umber, which is a warm brown, it may not push the green as far into the distance as the French ultramarine, which, while dulling the colour, also cools the colour because of the blue, which further enhances the effect of adding distance. If I'm painting a scene and I already want a dull green, the dullest green I can mix is with just French ultramarine and raw umber. And this gives me a very grey, barely green colour. And I might start with that. I can add a little bit more blue to it. There we go. I might start with that. If I think this is too grey, it's easy for me to add a small amount of the aureolin, and that gives me a little bit more of a green tint to it. And then I can continue to modify that. So if I add more yellow, and then if I want to adjust it by effectively adding more blue and yellow at the same time, which is what turquoise is, cobalt turquoise is, I can do that. More yellow. But keep in mind that these are all grey greens. They're not vibrant greens like that. But I start, if I already know the green I want is quite dark and dull, I will start with the French ultramarine and the raw umber and then modify it with the other two. When I have a bright green, I'll start with the cobalt turquoise and the aureolin and modify that with the other two. As our greens move further away, as they tend to become bluer. So again, if I look at my four colours, if I start with my bright green again, if I want to push that further back, just like I did here, I can add a small amount of French ultramarine, and that will start to cool that down. And depending on how far I want to push it back, I will play around with the amount of French ultramarine that I mix. But in addition to that, I will also be adding more water to the mix. So I can add a little bit more blue, not that much blue, and more water. So what happens here is I'm doing two things. Maybe a little bit more blue. So I'm adding more blue, but also more water at the time. So I'm combining the atmospheric effect of a colour becoming bluer, but also lighter. The other thing that happens in the distance is you also get edges becoming softer, which is why you quite often see people painting distant hills wet on wet to create this soft edge. While the four colours I've spoken about up until now are the main colours I use when mixing greens, probably 95% of my greens are mixed with them. This chart here I produced just to give you an idea how you can, there are so many other ways to mix greens and different shades of greens, and from bright greens to quite dull greens. And these are just some colours from my palette. It's not a complete list. I've produced it just to give you an idea that there are many different ways to produce green. So in this chart, all I've got is some colours that have yellows in them, and along the top I've got bluish colours, and then I've just mixed each colour with each of the other colours. And I think you can see from this green just how wide a range of colours you can produce. And this is just mixing two colours together. If you add a third colour, then obviously the range is expanded incredibly. And then if you start lightening the colour and then varying the amount of each colour, you have an infinite range of greens you can mix with these colours that are on the screen at the moment. Another topic I want to briefly discuss is that of using tube greens. Now, I rarely use tube greens, but obviously over the years I have collected a number of them. And I produced this chart here. Along the top, I've got Viridian, Winsor Green Yellow Shade, Winsor Green Blue Shade, Hooker's Green, and Permanent Sap Green. And along here, a range of yellows and French ultramarine, just to throw in a blue component. And again, just mixing each of these colours up here with each of these colours, you can see the range of colours you can produce. And more importantly, by adding these other colours to the tube greens, one, you can produce a much bigger range of greens, but also you can create more expressive and interesting greens, in my humble opinion, anyway. And the blues can be used to cool those greens further, and also to increase their tone. So when we get to sap green with French ultramarine here, we're getting very close to a black.